How's it going, everybody? We've got a new PlayStation Store sale, and I do believe this is the first Deal Mania sale. How about that? We got a new title for one of these sales. Deal Mania, I don't know, don't quote me on it. I feel like I've been covering these PlayStation Store sales for years at this point, and I do not recall covering a Deal Mania. I've recalled covering Planet of the Discounts, Extended Play, PlayStation Hits. I mean, I can go on and on. I feel like I would remember the verbiage that they use, but you know what? Deal Mania, this is pretty cool. I mean, it's not really that cool. I mean, I'm grasping at straws here to call things cool, but for my old ass at this point, this is pretty cool. We do have 2,100 items on sale, but let's filter this through the full games, game bundles, and premium editions, and that will knock it down to 1,550 titles. Maybe that eliminates some NBA, I was about to say NBA Sharp Cards, GTA Sharp Cards, NBA. I don't know if there's DLC to the NBA games that are listed. I think they have their own shop or whatever and all of that. Good stuff, or if you want to perceive it as good stuff. Let's talk these deals. GTA 5, $14.99 for the PS4 version. At this point, you probably want the PS5 version if you're picking that game up. Red Dead 2, $19.79. We're never going to get an upgrade, so it is what it is. Suicide Squad, Kill the Justice League, $21 on that. Skull and Bones, $28 on that, guys. Now, should I be happy that both of those games flopped? I mean, I don't think I should. There are people that work very hard on those games, and it would have been nice if those games were just worthwhile. But Ubisoft be Ubisoft, and recently, and Warner Brothers ain't my favorite publisher these days. However, I did quite enjoy Hogwarts Legacy, and the PS5 version is down to $21, and I gotta say, that's a really good deal for Hogwarts Legacy, and I have no care whatsoever for Harry Potter, but I like that game fundamentally from its gameplay. Thought it was well done, and I had some friends that were a little bit down on the replayability of the game and the post-game content and things of that nature, but I felt like Hogwarts Legacy is like my kind of open world game, a little bit more contained. You can finish it, you know, in 30 hours, 30 to 40 hours. You're gonna have a good time doing all of the content, or at least some of the content. And it doesn't overstay its welcome, which these days I think that's very important for games. And these games are just getting bigger and bigger. And I just think it doesn't, they don't need to be. And Hogwarts Legacy, I found, it found a good middle ground for that. WWE 2K24 Deluxe is $60. Grounded is $24. Star Wars Jedi Survivor still chilling at that $31.49 range. It is baked into EA Play now, so if you do sign up for that, $5.99 a month, you got access to games like Jedi Survivor, games like Dead Space Remake. But you guys know how I feel about Jedi Survivor. I think the game is absolutely tremendous, and I would highly, highly recommend it. Grand Theft Auto 5 on PS5. Okay, so it is on sale. It's $19.99. I don't know why they aren't listed next to each other, but $19.99 on that. I mean, it's GTA 5. It's a great game. I know we meme on GTA Online, Shark Cards, and everything like that, but if you're one of the two people that haven't played GTA 5, I would definitely play it. I've always been more of a Red Dead guy. I've said that over and over again, that the serious tone of Red Dead and Wild West has just become one of those themes and settings that I really do, that really does resonate with me. But GTA is always going to be a good time, and yeah, GTA 5 for $19.99, not a bad deal there. It Takes Two, $13.99, great co-op game there. Avatar Frontiers of Pandora, $35. At this point, like, you want the Ultimate Edition at a good price, because you guys at this point know how Ubisoft does their game. You want all the content. The Ultimate Edition is 50% off for $65, which is highway robbery. This is a game that should be, you know, $20 for the Ultimate Edition, and that's not a stretch. $20 for the Ultimate Edition is what you should be paying. Look, Ubisoft can do what they want to do as far as pricing their games at launch at $130. My perception of them is, I'm gonna call it as it is, and Avatar Frontiers of Pandora is a game that the Ultimate Edition, you should wait for it to be $20, and then if you like open world titles, you'll have an enjoyable experience, all things considered. Red Dead 1 is still $35, kinda has settled into that price point. Maybe it'll get a little bit cheaper. Dead Island 2, $34.99 on that, 50% off. Not a great price for Dead Island 2. That's another game. You wanna get the Gold Edition for that, for the DLC. That's $45. The game at this point is 16 months old, 18 months actually. believe it was February of 2023 when it came out. Maybe it was April. 16 to 18 months old. $45 is egregious in my opinion. Wait for that to be sub 20 bucks. Could see it get baked into PS Plus Extra at some point as well. Hitman World of Assassination for $28 is really good. No Man's Sky for $24. I mean, that game gets perpetually updated. So yes, while it is 8 years old, they've been dropping free update after free update with that game. And the game it is now is very much different than what it was back in, 2016. Assassin's Creed Valhalla, $15. Valhalla Complete is $34.99. I liked Valhalla in a lot of ways. Obviously, you guys know how I feel about the new Assassin's Creed games, but I really do dig the Viking setting. The issue with Valhalla is it's one of those games that did really overstay its welcome. You do have all of the DLC in here as well, so if you pick up Valhalla Complete Edition, obviously, clear up some weekends because it is going to be quite the undertaking for you to get through. But, $35 on that. Crew Motorfest Gold Edition is $40. I mean, it's another Ubisoft open world title. Last of Us Part 1 is $39.89. Like, guys, that game came out, what? Was it fall of 2022? 2 years ago. Yeah, I believe it was September of 2022. And that's still $40. Look, I love Last of Us 1 as much as the next guy. It is legitimately one of my favorite games of all time. But $40 for what was already overpriced at $70 when it came out 2 years ago is just an absolutely insane price point. And again, I love Last of Us 1. It's a game that if you... I'm sure there are people out there that are just like, bro, it's not going to get any cheaper. Let me just buy it. Yeah, sure. Go that route and buy it if you want, but at some point, this game's just gotta get cheaper. Or is it gonna get added to Plus Extra? I mean, they'll add it to Plus Extra and then they'll pull it from Plus Extra with how things been going recently. But yeah, that's just so wild that that's still $40. Mortal Kombat 11 is $4.99. Banishers Ghost of New Eden, 30% off for $42. Certainly gonna be one of the sleeper games of 2024. Not a game that you should probably pay this price point for, but once it gets down to that $15 to $20 range, check out Banishers. I think a lot of you guys are going to be pleasantly surprised by it. Done by Don't Nod Entertainment, the same guys that brought you Vampire, which is another game that I think is a little bit of a sleeper. DBZ Kakarot Deluxe Edition is $19.54. If you want to play DBZ Kakarot at this point, you should be looking to pick up the Legendary Edition, I believe it's called. Yeah, the Legendary Edition, which is not on sale. It's $120, but when it goes on sale, it's like $40. That's what you want to get with the extra season pass. It makes it well worth it, but DBZ Kakarot is quite good. GTA Trilogy, the Definitive Edition. GTA 3, San Andreas, Vice City, $30 on that. I mean, it's not going to get any cheaper. Rockstar games usually get to a low price, and then they settle at that low price of $20, $30, and it's very, very rare they get even cheaper. In this case, GTA Trilogy has been $30 for a while, and if you do want it, I would just say go ahead and pick it up. Hi-Fi Rush, 40% off for $17.99. You guys already know how I feel about that game. That game is absolutely tremendous, and I highly, highly recommend it. Definitely go check that out. Watch Dogs 1 and 2, the bundle for $9 is quite good. Watch Dogs 2, the base game, is also $4.99. And Watch Dogs 2 Gold Edition for $7.99. Those are some sleeper really good deals. Like, Watch Dogs 2, I think from a narrative and a tone standpoint, isn't as good as Watch Dogs 1, but there's a lot of elements that Watch Dogs 2 did really well. Unfortunately, Watch Dogs is an IP. Looks like it's pretty much cooked from Ubisoft as far as that's concerned, but hey, Watch Dogs 2 for $4.99, I think is pretty good. And that bundle for both Watch Dogs 1 and 2 for $9, that's also a pretty good deal. Star Wars Battlefront 2 is $6. Star Wars Skywalker Saga Galactic Edition is $19.99. This was recently in PS Plus, so a lot of you guys picked it up that way, but if you want the bonus content, the Galactic Edition isn't a bad pickup. Dragon Ball Xenoverse 2, the Special Edition, is 50% off for $24.99, and if you want to pick up Xenoverse 2 at this point, that is probably the version of the game that you want to get, being that it's $25 at this point. This gets you the Super Pass 1, Super Pack 1 through 4, I should say. And then you also get the Hero of Justice Pack, which, there's a lot of notable content in there. Gohan Beast is just, they've added that to Dragon Ball Xenoverse. Gohan Beast, obviously, in the more recent Dragon Ball movie, but that's a pretty recent thing to be adding to a game from 2016, but Xenoverse is a good time. Like, if you like the character creation stuff, you'll have an enjoyable experience with it. As far as my taste with the Dragon Ball game goes, Xenoverse isn't necessarily the style of game that I want, but you know what? It's fine, and for a lot of people, it's going to really resonate with them. Crash Bandicoot Insane Trilogy, $16. The Quarry is $17.49. Star Wars Jedi Fallen Order is $9.99, and it seems like that price point has kind of gotten jacked up for Jedi Fallen Order. It is what it is. It's a great game. but it used to go on sale for like $4. Assassin's Creed Odyssey Ultimate Edition, $24 on that. That's a really good deal. AC Odyssey, out of the newer style AC games, is really, by most people, seems to be the one that they enjoy the most. And you get AC 3 remastered in the Ultimate Edition of AC Odyssey. So you get another game, you get the DLC. You know, that's a pretty good pickup from a value standpoint. Alone in the Dark, one of the flops of this year as far as commercial reception goes, $42 on that. Still probably a little bit too expensive. Persona 5 Royal, though, for $24, I think that's quite good. And obviously beloved as a JRPG. Mafia Trilogy, Mafia 1, 2, and 3 for $15. That is really, really good. $5 a pop. That is a damn good pickup. And given that we're going to get a new Mafia title next year, not a bad time to catch up on all Mafia. Metro Exodus is $4.49, but the Metro Saga bundle for $9, always a good pickup there. And I recommend that ad nauseum. So there you go with that. Sonic Superstars, 50% off for $29.99. You know, that physically, I really do believe is going to be super cheap come this holiday. So if you're okay with picking up disc-based games, I would say wait for, you know, Black Friday, and I could see that being down to like $14.99. Might be the optimal route to go with that. Aiden Chronicle 100 Heroes getting cheaper and cheaper, 35% off for $32.49. Will say I don't think this is cheap enough. I think at $19.99 this is a good pickup. There's a lot of things I wanted to like about this game, and there's a lot of elements I did like about the game. It's just so dated, and I get that it's supposed to be a love letter, a throwback to Suikoden, but, you know, you can be a love letter to a old franchise while at the same time modernizing a lot of elements of it, and Aiden Chronicle really faltered as far as that's concerned. And, yeah, the narrative isn't that great. $32.49, not a bad price given it's a recent release, but I would say wait for it to be cheaper. Civilization 6 is $4.49. Tiny Tina's Wonderlands for PS4 is $12. The Chaotic Great Edition is $17.99. Jujutsu Kaisen Curse Clash. You guys want me to go on my Curse Clash rant again? The game's terrible. One of the worst games legitimately of all time. One of the worst anime games of all time. And that's wild that I can't say it is the worst anime game of all time because the game is absolute garbage. But yeah, anime games have been garbage in a lot of instances. So let's just say Curse Clash is terrible. And I know JJK is beloved as an anime, but that game is an abomination and one of the bigger cash grabs you're going to come across. Assassin's Creed Origins is $9. Injustice 2, $3. Back for Blood, $6 on that. Wreckfest is $14.99. LA Noire, another one of those Rockstar games that's gone to its price point and ain't getting any cheaper. It's just settled at that $20 price point, which isn't bad, but, you know, it is what it is. Forspoken, still $28. Come on, man. That's been, like, 20 months since Forspoken's come out. That should be down to, like, $15, and that certainly will be a PS Plus extra title in the very near future. Mass Effect Legendary Edition, $9. Bioshock The Collection, $9.99. Ultimate Marvel vs. Capcom 3, $7.49. Uncharted Nathan Drake Collection, $9.99. Dying Light Definitive Edition is $9.99 as well. Pretty good deal there. But that'll do it for... Actually, really, do want to give a shout to Persona 3 Reload Digital Deluxe. 40% off for $48. You know what? That's actually not that great of a deal, all things considered, given you don't get the DLC. For some reason, I was just thinking you did get the DLC with that, but then, yeah, remember, you don't. Because Sega and Atlas, gonna be Sega and Atlas again. Earth Defense Force 6 recently just dropped. That's also 20% off for $48. Literally like a month and a half old or so. So super recent title there for $48. But that'll do it for me. Again, a lot of deals available across the board on the PlayStation Store. Check them out for yourself. And that's page 5 of 65 pages. So a lot more to cover. But that'll do it for me again. Your thoughts down below. Sound off there. Thank you for watching and goodbye. Hey guys, we hope you enjoyed the video, and if you did, make sure to hit the subscribe button, and if you're already subscribed, do us a favor and hit the bell icon. This way you'll be notified whenever we post a new video. That's the best way to keep up with all of our uploads, and we usually try to upload 2 videos a day. And with the bell icon hit, you'll be notified whenever we do upload a video. As always, thanks for watching.